Hi, everyone. I'm Shravya, and I lead engineering teams exploring the latest advancements of AI in health. Listening to everything that's been shared today, it's clear that AI is providing new opportunities to scale health solutions, helping everyone, everywhere, access the care they need. And to create meaningful change in health, we know it's not just about building the technology. It's also about collaborating with local governments, researchers, and NGOs to design new solutions. By enabling our partners with tools and technology, we have an unprecedented opportunity here to solve real global health challenges. So let's start with the critical area of maternal health. As you already saw in our video, we've been working with the OnTime Consortium, which is a partnership of policymakers, doctors, and researchers to develop a tool that predicts travel times to emergency obstetric care facilities. It was built using the same AI that powers Google Maps today to help us understand gaps in geographic access. And this, in turn, can help us identify where expecting mothers need improved access to care. Nigeria was the first country to adopt this tool in 2023 as part of its broader initiative to decrease maternal mortality. And already, it has enabled decision makers and organizations in Nigeria to allocate resources more effectively. For instance, it's helped the Edo state government and a network of community first responders called Emergency Response Africa. Based on insights from this tool, they're strategically relocating first responders to areas where women might face longer travel times to reach care. And that is why today, we're excited to announce the expansion of this tool to Ghana, a country that is similarly committed to reducing maternal mortality through innovative approaches. And we look forward to bringing this tool to more countries in the coming months. But of course, access to care isn't just about geography. In many parts of the world, even when people can reach a healthcare facility, resources and expertise may be stretched very thin. So let's explore how AI can address some of these challenges for tuberculosis, or TB, which even today remains a leading cause of mortality globally. Chest x-rays can help with TB screenings, but often there aren't enough trained radiologists in TB endemic areas to interpret these images. And last year at the checkup, at this very stage, we shared how AI can help bridge some of that gap through an AI system to screen for TB from chest x-rays, making screenings more accurate and accessible to help patients start treatments faster. And since then, we're partnered with Apollo Radiology International, a leading provider of radiological services, and Nexus Intelligence, a pioneering medical AI company specializing in lung health screening, to roll out the system in India, Southeast Asia, and Africa. Apollo has already conducted over 100,000 AI-powered chest x-ray screenings, and they'll be expanding this effort as part of their broader commitment to provide 3 million free screenings over the next decade. And upon obtaining regulatory approval, Nexus will scale its AI product. They've committed to donating and supporting over 100,000 free TB screenings in under-resourced communities across Africa. To further expand access to TB care in rural India, we have also partnered with Kushi Baby, which is a digital health nonprofit, reaching over 50 million people through 75,000 healthcare workers. Kushi Baby has integrated Google's Open Health Stack, which is a set of tools for developing Android healthcare apps to roll out a community-based TB screening program in India's largest state of Rajasthan, starting with the most vulnerable population there. Across the board, this type of impact is only possible because of advancements of AI and platforms like Android combined with our on-the-ground collaborations. Another way for us to potentially catch TB early is through the power of sound, like the simple sound of a cough, because subtle clues that are hidden within bioacoustics have the potential to screen for a wide range of health conditions. and this can pave the path for a more accessible method for TB screenings, for instance, using the mic on your phone. And that is why last year, we introduced health acoustic representations, or HEAR, which is an acoustic foundation model to help researchers build models that can flag early signs of disease based on respiratory sounds. We have seen endorsement for this approach from the Stop TB Partnership, which is a United Nations-hosted organization that brings together TB experts with affected communities. And today, I'm excited to announce that HEAR will be publicly available through our Health AI Developer Foundations. This makes it easier for developers to explore their ideas faster, building their own custom models with less data, setup, and computation. We've already seen great community engagement with these open-weight AI models, and we're excited to see what developers build next with them. By making tools like Open Health Stack and Health AI Developer Foundations available, we are putting our technology in the hands of others to expand what's possible. Because only by bringing together technology and partnerships do we have the potential to improve access to care for everyone, everywhere.